wanted something from me. You've been given nothing. Oh, I've been wanting something from me. You've been given nothing. Oh.
So what's going on, guys? So as y'all know, I am doing the diet. I already went over like a review and kind of like an update on my diet. So today I wanted to go over pretty much tips I found useful during this diet. Alrighty, let's start with tip number one. So with tip number one, the thing I would say is find meals that you can stick to. So like, you don't want to find like a very boring diet like rice, broccoli, and like chicken or tilapia. And it gets very, you know, repetitive, annoying, boring, whatever you want to call it. What I would recommend, you know, you could find things like French toast in the morning, you can make smoothies, you can find like healthy pizza recipes like the one I made, quick plug, and you know, just like good recipes that you can follow, and it'll make losing weight a lot easier. So that's what I've been using, and that's something that you can try as well. So let's move on to number two. Now for number two, something that I've been honestly pushing myself for is like, honestly, there's times where I'm like, why am I doing this thing? So then like I start like kind of like getting into this kind of like negative state. So the way to get out of that negative state is very easy. What you have to do is just kind of like be like, you have to remember why you started and motivate yourself. So you got to motivate the crap out of yourself. So you got to be like, okay, I started because let's say I'm too skinny or I want muscle. I want to like be able to take the shirt off and like, you know, look good. I want to, whatever your motivation is, remind why you started and just keep pushing. And honestly, that's like the, like one of the sacred steps I follow, because you just kind of like have to like go ahead and reflect as to why you started and just enjoy the process. So let's move on to number three. Alrighty, and number three. So honestly, a lot of people don't really talk about this one, but there is some days where you might do more activity than others. Like you might go on a hike, like what I am right now. As you can see, there's nature. And like if you go on a hike or you do more physical activity than another day that you would, honestly, what I would say is account for that. So go ahead and eat a little bit more. It's okay. You're not going to affect yourself because you ate 100, 200, 300, or maybe even, let's say you can get away with like 400 calories. You will not get it won't hurt your diet. So you can eat a little bit more of a surplus that day if you're more active. So like that, it won't hurt your gains, or you just won't feel very, very like, you know, like unmotivated and sick and, you know, weak. So you want to feel great, and you have to account for what you did. So if you did a couple more steps, if you did a couple more miles, go ahead and account for that and go ahead and eat a little bit more. So it's not going to hurt you, or you could even go ahead and call it a refeed. So if you feel very weak, like I've told you before with my coach, I go ahead and tell him like, hey bro, like I feel a little weak. You have to be honest with yourself, with your coach, and then just be like, hey, I might need a refeed, which refeed is just going to go ahead and help store more glycogen, and you're gonna have a better output into your workouts, into your social life, into life in general. So that's what I would recommend, and go ahead and do more research on that as well. But you know, the more activity level you do, a little bit more calories that you can, you know, go ahead and input into your diet that day. So go ahead and follow this as well. This one's also very, very helpful, and it helps me, because if not, I'd be a grouch all the time. So kind of to recap the third one, I feel like I didn't really do too well at explaining, but I feel with the number three about the whole, like, you know, the refeed or even eating a little bit more calories, you have to, like I said, you have to like look at your daily routine, and if you feel like you're expedited more calories burnt, it's okay to add 100 more calories. So it's okay to add, let's say in the morning you ate like 30 French toast normally, it's okay if you eat 4. Or, and then you add a little bit more chicken breast, or you, wherever, it doesn't matter where you get your calories from, but it's totally okay, and don't freak out. And even if, like, let's say you are a little bit hungrier, I'd say go with a little bit something more satiating. Like you could do sugar-free Jell-O, or you can do like let's say some rice cakes or some fruit. Like watermelon has a lot of volume. You can do cucumbers, like I believe, and I've always talked about cucumbers, you chop them up, I think 2 cups is like 20 calories. So I mean, at the end of the day, 20 more calories isn't gonna hurt. So I hope that makes a little bit more sense, but let's move on to number four. Alrighty, so number four. I know I've talked about this on this channel before, about the whole recovery thing. So a big step that I have been using during this diet as well is listening to my body. So sometimes, like, if I'm like, okay, you know what? I really can't do it today. Like, I just feel, you know, like I've been overworking myself. a rest day a week is not bad, you know what I mean? Like one rest day, like I've had that mentality where like I'm just like, nah, grind time, bro, grind time. Like I have to go over here, I have to, you know, like just work hard. And yes, that's true, work hard, but honestly, as long as you have maybe even one day of just recovery and like, you know, just focus on yourself, you can like listen to the podcast, you know, go ahead and do something, read some books, do whatever, it doesn't matter, but just go ahead and focus on yourself for one day, and trust me, that's going to keep you like mentally like sane, and you're not, it's going to change you out of, it's going to get you out of routine as well as just working hard. And you know, even if it's like in school, work in general, not just losing weight, it's good to go ahead and take a day to, you know, kind of like a mental vacation. So that's what I would recommend. Mental vacations are great. They're good for sanity, because trust me, if I would not take any breaks, I'd be insane or crazy. Alrighty guys, so number five. So on this one, it's gonna be more about going out to eat. So if you get invited to eat, don't make the mistake I used to make a lot when I first started dieting. So like people would invite me to go out to eat and I'd get that anxiety, or like I'd be nervous whenever the waiter or waitress would come and I'm still looking at the menu and I'm like, what's healthy? Should I get a salad? Should I get this? And I have that mental battle and I'm like, what should I get? And I end up getting burgers, fries, cheese, and all this extra stuff. And I'm like, I just screwed up my diet. Whenever, what you can do is most of the time nowadays, some mom and pop shops don't do this, by the way, but what I would do, go online, look up the information and pick good choices. Like if they're like, if you go to a steakhouse, you can get like lean steak, especially if you like have the calories remaining for all that, you could get like lean steak with like, you know, potatoes with like no butter, or maybe like light butter and no cheese, and just like enjoy yourself that way, and get broccoli, or maybe even get grilled chicken with like a side salad, and like low fat ranch or anything like that. You can make those choices. Just look online for the nutritional facts, which I find it really helpful with like, I don't know if y'all have this, but like Chipotle, you know, Chick-fil-A, even like I said, that smoothie place that I go to a lot, they have that online, so you can go ahead and make better choices rather than, you know, just be nervous and be like, wow, that seems healthy, let me get it, and then it's not healthy and you just kind of fall off on your diet. So don't stress about it too much, but that's something I'd recommend if you want to be in the ballpark with your numbers. So that's definitely what I would recommend. Alrighty guys, so that being said, I hope y'all understand what I'm trying to say. Like, you know, you don't really have to stress out too much about this whole situation about dieting. You can fit into your lifestyle. That, those are the first five things that I wanted to talk about, because to me, they're very important. You don't want to stress out too much about it. Of course, right now, I'm not necessarily following every approach, because I'm not really eating out too much, just because right now I'm trying to, like, you know, follow my coach's plan. But that being said, that's the way I usually do it whenever I diet myself, or I even diet clients that aren't trying to compete or anything like that, because I'm more of a like lifestyle coach. I'm not really like somebody that's like, okay, you're gonna, you know, compete tomorrow, or you're gonna compete like in a year or whatever. No, that's not me. So that being said, I hope this advice helps y'all guys, and if y'all have any questions, please comment below. But that being said, please like and subscribe, and we'll see y'all on the next one, guys. Peace.